Welcome to ASOC Tutorials India program, a platform to learn Amateur Station Operator Certificate License Examination in India. First, ASOC Tutorials India program aiming to provide free quality education to students preparing for Amateur Ham Radio Examination in India. The Amateur Station Operator Examination ASOC is conducted by the Ministry of Communication, Government of India, time to time. And today my session is on Jana diode as a voltage regulator, part 4. This topic is without calculation, so not meant for G or any other competition entrance exam. So coming to the topic, first, Jana diode as a voltage regulator. A Jana diode is a silicon semiconductor device that permits current to flow in either a forward or reverse direction. The symbol is shown on your screen. The diode consists of a special heavily doped PN junction designed to conduct in the reverse direction when a certain specified voltage is reached. Additionally, the voltage drop across the diode remains constant over a wide range of voltage, a feature that makes Jana diode suitable for use in voltage regulation. The voltage regulator is used for two main reasons. First, to vary or regulate the output voltage, and second, to keep the output voltage constant at the desired value despite of variation in the input supply voltage. So during forward bias, the Jana diode behave like a normal conventional or single diode. But when the reverse voltage is applied to it, the voltage remains constant for a wide range of currents. If you see a plot A voltage and current diagram as shown on your screen, first when it comes to a forward bias, first slightly forward voltage will flow, a negligible current will flow, and at a one moment when it cross its knee value, knee voltage, this knee voltage is the forward voltage add with the flow of the current through the PN junction of the diode increases rapidly. It already explained in the previous sessions also. So when it come to the reverse, because of carriers, holes and electron, a leakage current will flow, but a moment will come when this breakdown voltage, also called Jana voltage, comes. Then this diode suddenly allow full flow of current. Because it is heavily doped semiconductor, it will not damage. But on other side, the ordinary PN junction or rectifier signal diode, they can damage because of a very huge current flow. But this Jana diode, because it is heavily doped, it can sustain its property. The moment voltage is coming below a Jana point, it will come a, as usual, normal diode. But when it increases, it will work again as a Jana diode. And due to this feature of Jana diode, it is used as a voltage regulator in DC circuit to maintain a constant voltage output, or I can say regulated voltage. How it works? I have shown a simple diagram on your screen. When the input voltage is coming, the RS, this resistance series, is connected to the circuit in order to limit the current into the Jana diode, which can, if there is a high current, it can damage. So this one is used on very low current. So this one is Jana diode connected in series. What happened? The series resistor limit the current through the diode and the drop the excess voltage when the diode is conducting. It works in such a way that reverse bias can also work in breakdown condition. It can work in both. Since the input voltage and the required output voltage is known, we know what is the input voltage approximately, what is our required voltage, it is easier to choose a suitable Jana diode rating with a voltage approximately equal to the load voltage shown on as a RL to Jana voltage VZ. So we can design it. This is one of the simplest voltage regulator which you can understand as a application. This action of regulating continues infinitely, ensuring a fixed stabilized output voltage equivalent to the generating. So how this one work? Just showing you one of the example so that you can understand its application. Essentially, a series regulator is a variable resistance created using a transistor attached in series with one of the supply lines and to the load. Because we are taking more current, so we are using a transistor to drive it. Just Janner diode is giving a reference voltage, but to give a load as a buffer, we are using a transistor as a Q1. The resistance of a transistor to current automatically adjusts depending on the output load, such that the output voltage remains constant at a desired level. In a series regulator circuit, the input current has to be slightly more than the output current. The small difference is the only magnitude of the current that is utilized by the regulator circuit on its own, as shown on your screen. Advantages of series regulators are, first, the primary advantages of a series regulator circuit compared to the shunt type regulator, as shown in previous slide, is its better efficiency. The result is minimal dissipation of power and wastage through heat. Because of this great advantage, series transistor regulators are very popular in high power voltage regulators applications. Just going more on this topic, now coming with a sample numerical, don't see the value, it is just an example to demonstrate only. For actual values, go to the proper circuits. The transistor is connected as a voltage follower and the output voltage is approximately 0.6 to 0.7 volt, lower than the Janner voltage because of this one is inside PN junction value. This one will be different, will be there. The resistor R must be sized in such a way that the Janner diode is correctly polarized and the base current of Q1 shown on your screen is sufficient to bring its conduction. To prevent the current on the Janner from falling to a value not compatible with the Janner effect, if we are using more current, more capacity, and this transistor is not capable to drive such load, then we had to use powerful transistor or a Darlington transistor is required. What is Darlington pair? Students are asking. Just showing on your screen, two transistors working as a cascade, they are called Darlington pair. So this is just an explanation only without calculation. Just this is working of a Janner diode, how it works. Next part is continue to this one is regulated power supply and using of LC filter, how to convert pulsating DC to plain filter DC. So this is end of my today's session. Hope you like it. I am continue with this topic and next part will be on basic knowledge of LC filters using pi filters, L filters, T filters and many more. If you like it, kindly subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much. I am continue with next sessions.